Hi everybody, it's Ben Harvey and welcome to the Bubble Golf Coaching channel on YouTube. Guys, I've got a really good post for you this week and it's about plotting your way around the golf course. So not enough of us plot our way around the golf course in terms of having a pre-shot routine, picking the exact club that you want to hit, picking the exact type of shot that you want to hit, and eventually getting to that point where you step up onto the ball and you hit that type of shot and everything's planned out. The problem we have as members of golf courses is we get into those routines. You know exactly sort of what club you're going to hit on every single hole before you've even started your round. Now the problem is you've got different conditions, you've got different grass conditions on the course. The course might be playing slower, it might be playing faster. But a lot of people, they get into that routine of not actually studying their golf course. They don't plot their way round, so they make their percentage of scoring a lot easier. So recently last week I was playing with a client and we were going around the golf course on one of my local golf courses and I was giving her a quick playing lesson for about 9 holes and I wanted to see how she played. So I spent more time really caddying than I did hitting golf balls. So we're going around, we're picking the type of shots we want to play, where do you want to go, and it was incredible to watch her when, if I wasn't there, she would just play the same shot every single time. So she knew exactly every single hole. She'd play the same club, she'd do the same thing. What I'd like you guys to do is plot your way round a golf course and pick different types of shots that you want to play. Pick landing areas and as well pick safe zones. Now the golf course that we're walking around, I've played it for quite some years and I used to play it every day, so I know the course as good as anybody does. And what we did, we slowly worked on what clubs to take for each shot and we played the course to an exact landing area as well. It amazes me how much I play with golfers and they have no game plan whatsoever. So they have no thought process and they don't know how they want to play the golf course. So I ask many golfers and they believe that game plans are just professionals who can hit the shots that they see nearly every single time. So why would you think that? Every golfer can have a game plan and how they want to play the golf course. What I'd like to explain to my clients is that even though we might not pull off those shots every single time or as much as the pros do, we can still do it. Now, not having a game plan is kind of like turning up to the golf course with no golf clubs. You have no idea where you're going to go and you don't have a clear path of what score you're going to shoot. You don't have a clear path of where that ball's going to go. So you need to give yourself a game plan and you need to plot your way around the golf course. It's kind of like the same thing where you would set on a mission to drive from Glasgow to London, but you've got no roadmap. How the hell are you going to get there? So it's the same as sending the golf ball on its journey, or sending the golf ball to its home, as Happy Gilmore likes to say. Get in your home, ball. And something cool that looks nice is you've got to make sure that you have a nice little notepad. So get a cool looking notepad, and when you play different golf courses, or you play your golf course, write down notes on the pad, you know, on the 13th green. It slopes from right to left, but doesn't break as much as you think it does. Make little small notes that you can remember for the next time you play. Every golf course has got its own little niches and the different ways the ball's going to bounce, and it's got different landing areas. If you look at most golf courses, most holes have got safe zones. So safe zones mean landing areas that if you hit a bad shot or you miss the green, you know that you're not going to end up in a bunker, you're going to end up maybe just left of the flag and in some semi-rough. Always look for the safe areas and think about it. Think about the types of shots that you're playing. Think about where you're going. Golf is a thinking person's game. It's not a game where you just rock up and there's no thinking involved, there's no planning. There's planning for every single shot. And you've got to take the wind into account as well at the same time, and the weather conditions. So every course that you're going to play is going to play completely differently every single day. But every golf course that you play is going to have its consistencies. So guys, think about that. Think about the next time you go out onto the golf course, plot your way around. And I can guarantee you that you're going to shoot a hell of a lot better score having a game plan, writing down notes, picking the right clubs, and not always picking the shot which goes straight down the hole. Don't always aim at the hole all the time. Before I finish, look at clear physics. If you were to aim at the hole every single shot, directly at the hole, you're always going to finish up further away from the hole than you do closer. I'm going to put out another video and another blog post later on today, which is going to be more about the physics of the game and how you're plotting your way around the golf course, but sort of like a stage two to this video. So guys, stay tuned and I'll catch you soon and have a good one. Next time you play, get in your bubble and I'll speak to you soon.